Is nature innovative? Can it create the complexity of life? Good day, everyone. So, it turns out nature does not like order. It actually likes chaos. It doesn't like special arrangements. It rather likes things to be even. According to the Second Law of Thermodynamics, entropy of the universe, or any closed system, increases. Let's explain this in simpler words. Entropy is the level of disorder, and the law states that it can only increase. It means that if you leave a natural system or process to behave freely, it will tend to be more disordered. If there is any special arrangement in nature, nature will tend to even it out. That's why shapes in space, like planets and stars, tend to become spheres, because a sphere is an even shape. That's why a very hot object cools and a block of ice melts. And that's why a perfume in a room will spread out in the room until it's evenly distributed. So let's think of it like this. You bring a group of kids in a playground, you ask them to stand in a row, and then you set them free. Order was high, so entropy was low. When you set them free, they have energy, they run around, they become disordered, and hence entropy increases. Our world is continuously degrading into disorder. Buildings crumble, tall statues fall apart, and your car will eventually need maintenance when it's broken. Entropy is the arrow of time. The more time runs, the more the system runs, the more the disorder, the more the system degrades and everything falls apart. But does nature go the other way? Absolutely not. If you have an inflated balloon and you let air flow out, air will not coincidentally come in again the same way it went out. Someone will have to grab the balloon, blow air in the balloon persistently. He will have to intend to do it until the balloon is full again, and then he will close the lid to prevent air from coming out. Everyone will know intuitively that air does not fill balloons on its own, because it's against the second law of thermodynamics. So how come things that are very complicated, very organized, and very articulate occur? Things like a Swiss watch, a smartphone, or a very nice piece of software. Well, the answer is obviously, these things are not products of nature. They did not happen spontaneously. They are the product of an intelligent mind, of a specific intent that exerted work to make them happen. And this is the only way they come to existence. And now we ask a question. Does it make any sense that life on our planet, including the human being, emerged from an entropic, blind, mindless process of nature? They claim that there is a process called abiogenesis. And what it means is that life emerged from sterile, barren, unliving material through a natural process of nature. Is it possible? It is absolutely impossible. Not only because of the absurdly low probabilities that are practically zero, but also because you cannot expect that nature will create complicated systems that will decrease its entropy. You cannot ask nature to do things that are against the laws of nature itself. You cannot expect nature to break the second law of thermodynamics. Let me quote for you Sir Arthur Eddington, a prominent English astronomer, physicist, and mathematician. He says, quote, "The law that entropy always increases holds, I think, the supreme position among the laws of nature." And he goes on, "If your theory is found to be against the second law of thermodynamics, I can give you no hope. There is nothing for it but to collapse in deepest humiliation. For life to happen in our entropic, hostile universe, we need the persistent hand and will of an intelligent being, a supreme being, to create the sheer complexity and beauty of life. A being who is external to this universe. We call him God. Thank you.